Not again?
What's wrong, Chlorine?
Just scientists being scientists. They're always favoring metals over nonmetals. It's like they have something against us.
Hey, Sodium, did you know milk was an element?
Oh, great. The element of milk. It's right up there with the element of surprise.
Oh, hi, Milk. Chlorine.
Would you stop calling me Milk?
What are you talking about anyway?
Metals.
Airplanes.
Wait, airplanes?
Yeah. We were thinking, why don't they make airplanes out of wood instead of metal? It's cheap. I run much more renewable.
Yeah, sure. Why don't we take it a step further? We could cover them up with leaves, fill them up with cute little ants, and use them to scare away angry grasshoppers.
Hey, you're the one who said scientists were against nonmetals.
I was just talking about metals in the periodic table. What do you think, Hydrogen?
What, me? Sorry, I got distracted. I just want to watch A Bug's Life again.
Seriously, though, what's wrong with the periodic table?
Well, just look at it.
Is that ketchup?
Looks okay to me.
See all the elements on the left? They're all metals. All the nonmetals are shoved off to a corner like an afterthought.
I'm not a metal.
Yeah, you're special, all right. I mean that in a good way. But those scientists discriminate against all the other nonmetals.
Discriminate? Aren't scientists supposed to have a code or something?
Yeah, like scientists' honor.
There ain't no such thing. Scientists might have honor, just not that kind.
Might have honor? You're just making it worse.
You know what I mean. It was scouts' honor.
Wow, I didn't know scouts wrote the periodic table.
It wasn't science scouts, silly. Chemists did in the 18th century.
Oh, 18th century chemists are the shiftiest. It was probably a grudge against chlorine or something.
Hey, you think it was that swimming pool smell?
Hey, I clean swimming pools. That's a good thing.
Really? Why do they call you group halogens then?
Halogens? That's terrible.
Hydrogen? You thought that means the same thing as hooligans, didn't you?
Oh, they're different things.
We should ask Oxygen.
Ask me what?
Oh, how long you been there?
Since the video started.
Just standing there. Dude, that's creepy.
Hey, Oxygen. What's that hooligan group?
Hooligans, halogens, are elements of group 17 on the periodic table. It is a highly reactive group of nonmetals.
That's exactly what I mean. Why do you have to call us highly reactive?
Because it is a scientific fact. Halogens have an incomplete outer electron shell and try to fill it by reacting with other elements.
That's just chemist propaganda.
It's a conspiracy. No, wait, it's a chemspiracy.
Wow, Hydrogen. Just wow.
Chemical reactivity is just science. Let me explain it this way. What do group 17 elements have in common?
They're all very good looking.
And modest too.
But chemically speaking, here's an idea. Why don't we take a closer look at a chlorine atom to explain?
Wait, is that mustard?
Wait, I see it.
Really? I was just kidding.
No, silly. Not mustard. I have 7 electrons in my outer shell. Come to think of it, all of us halogens have 7 electrons on the outside.
Exactly. Each atom has a number of electrons surrounding it in layers. All halogens have 7 electrons in their outer layer. Do you know what charge those electrons have?
Yeah, negative.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm positive.
Positive.
Electrons do have a negative charge. But what else is an atom made of? Imagination and the ability to make decisions based on moral judgment.
Thanks for the philosophy lesson, Socrates. What other components are there?
You're talking about the nucleus, right? It's the mass in the center, made of protons and neutrons.
Precisely. Neutrons carry no electrical charges. What about protons?
Protons have a positive charge.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm positive. Hey!
Okay, so we have positive protons and negative electrons. What does that have to do with being highly reactive?
Excellent question. Each atom has a set number of protons. Chlorine, for example, has 17 protons.
Really? I thought you only had 9.
9 protons? Do I look like fluorine to you?
How was I supposed to know? It ain't like you're wearing a tag.
I'm literally wearing a name tag with a number 17.
That kind of looks like an 8. You're sure you're not an 18?
Oh, stop it, you two. But if we were to imagine that you had 18 protons, what would change?
Well, I guess I wouldn't be chlorine anymore. I'd be argon. What?
Argon! From Lord of the Rings? Cool!
Thou art a truly noble gas, my lord. I will go with you to Mount Doom. You have my sword!
And my bow!
Hey, that's my bow! Give it back!
Really? You too, Oxygen?
But it is my bow!
Never mind that! I just want to know why you insist on calling us highly reactive!
Alright. Chlorine has 17 positively charged protons in its nucleus at all times. And it wants to attract 17 negatively charged electrons to balance them. However, a full electron shell fits 18 electrons, not 17.
But a full shell with 18 electrons is better! It's more stable, even if we end up with a negative 1 charge.
The point is, halogens react strongly to attract that last missing electron and complete the outer shell.
How would you even get an extra electron?
Ah, it does that by reacting with an element that wants to share an electron, like sodium.
I'm positively charged right now!
Your puns are electrifying today, sodium.
Okay, maybe highly reactive is a fair description, but we're not the only ones. Metals can be highly reactive too.
Well, hang on a second. Don't lump me in with that crowd. We may be reactive, but we don't just randomly take other elements' electrons.
It isn't a bad thing. Being highly reactive is why an element can be so essential in chemical reactions.
So, all of the elements are equally reactive?
Not exactly. Elements in the same group, like chlorine's halogens or sodium's alkali metals, react strongly.
So elements in the same group react the same?
Almost. Their electron shells make them chemically similar, but not quite the same. For example, sodium is much bigger than lithium. Both are highly reactive alkali metals, but they are distinct and different elements.
Ah, I see. That's why they're arranged in groups on the periodic table.
Precisely. Each group behaves in a certain way. While some react strongly, others are very unreactive.
Yeah, like the lazy atoms group.
Hmm? Oh, do you mean noble gases?
Noble gases. It's not fair to call them noble just because they're not reactive.
It just means they ignore forces that make other elements reactive. They have full and stable outer electron shells to begin with.
If chemists can call them noble gases, they should call us something nice too. Something like electron knights or royal elements.
Oh. How about full send hooligans?
Really? Full send hooligans? That's what you're going with?
Oh, you know, because you go all out to get your electrons. It makes sense.
Yeah, because 18th century chemists were known for their epic send-it culture.
And you know what else is not fair? Why does my character look like a gallon of milk?
A gallon of what?
How hard is it to draw an original character?
Go, full send chlorine.
You do look a bit like
me. Oh, you're going to break the
Thank you for watching. In the next episode, we delve deeper into the magic of alchemy. Make sure to stay tuned. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more mystical content from the wondrous world
of... Hey, Hydrogen! What are you doing?
I was just enchanting our audience with arcane knowledge about our upcoming episode.
Enchanting? Arcane? You do realize we're elements of science, not magic. Is this foreshadowing? And what's with the big words? And besides, you're talking directly to the audience. You're breaking the fourth wall.